There is a verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Itāvat janma-sāpannam dehinām iha dehishu prānai rathai dhyā-vācā śreya-ācaranam sadā. Itāvat janma-sāpannam. In order to make our life successful, dehinām iha dehishu, there are many embodied souls, 8,400,000 of species of life. Out of that, this civilized form of life, especially those who are followers of Vedic regulations, they are called the Aryans, are the advanced civilized persons. So, it is obtained after many, many evolutionary processes. Bhavanam janmanam ante. Labdha sudul, sudul labamidam bhavanam janmanam ante. So, dehinām iha dehishu, of all the embodied souls, this embodied soul, this human form of life, is meant for liberation. We are entangled in this chain of repeated birth and death, old age and disease. But we are not yet fed up. We think that, let us go on like this. But that is not actually advancement of knowledge. That is ignorance. There is a way to stop this repetition of birth, death, old age and disease. Therefore, in this age, in this life especially, we should try to get out of this entanglement. That is the special function of this human form of life. Dehinām iha dehis. There are many dehis. Dehis means one who accepts this material body. He is called dehi. In the Bhagavad Gita also it is said, kaumāra yauvana jara tathā dehāntaram prāpti dhīra-satya-na-rūpa. Dehinām iha dehishu. So dehi means, I am not this body, but I have accepted this body. Just like we accept a kind of dress, similarly, according to my desire, according to my karma, I have accepted a certain type of body, and according to that body, I am subject to different types of pains and pleasures. This is why. Therefore, Bhagavad says, especially in this body, it is the duty of everyone, śreya-ācaraṇam. There are two words in the Vedic literature, śreya and praya. Praya means, just like ordinarily, everyone is engaged in some sort of duty for sense gratification. Everyone is working very hard to satisfy the senses according to his standard of desire. But that is called praya, immediate benefit. But besides this praya, there is another department of activities which is called śreya. Just like children, they like to play. That is prayer. But his guardians are anxious that the child may not be spoiled, he may be educated for his future life. That is prayer. That is śreya. So Bhagavad says that in this life, We should not be after prayer, immediate benefit or immediate object of sense gratification. We should be thoughtful what I am, why I am put into these material conditions of life, and what is the way to get out of it. That is Sriya, Sriya Acharanam. So, people should be engaged in the human form of life for activities of ultimate goal of life, and that is Krishna or Vishnu, that we do not know. Nate vidu shaka gatini Vishnu. Being captivated by the external energy, maya, we have forgotten our interest. We are working for a different interest. That is Sriya, not for Sriya. The Sriya is Vishnu or Krishna. So I do not wish to take much of your time. You are all busy men. And I thank you very much that you have come. And we require your cooperation. Pranai Rathai Dhyavat. Somebody should dedicate his life for this great movement, Krishna consciousness. So these American boys, European boys, and there are some Indians also, they have dedicated their life for this purpose, to spread Krishna consciousness. Similarly, if one cannot dedicate his life, then he should dedicate his money as far as possible. According to our Goswami's program, everyone should sacrifice 50% of his income for Krishna. And Goswami, Rupa Goswami actually did it. It doesn't matter whether your income is 5 lakhs per month or 5 rupees per month. You should sacrifice the major portion of your income to the Supreme. If the government has got right to exact income tax from you, has not Krishna the right to exact income tax? He is supplying you so many things. Government, what government is supplying? Krishna is supplying you sunlight. Krishna is supplying you moonlight. Krishna is supplying you air. Krishna is supplying you food. Nitya nityanam chitana chitananam eka bhunam vidadati kama. Krishna is fulfilling all your desires. And don't you like to give him some tax? Don't lie. Krishna not only he's supplying, he's also begging. Just like he became a beggar to Bali Maharaj. Bamande. Bali Maharaj conquered the 3 worlds and all the demigods became very much perturbed. So Krishna as Bamande went to Bali Maharaj as a beggar. Maharaj, you are very charitable. Will you kindly give me 3 feet land? So Krishna, although he is the maintainer of everyone, sometimes he takes the part of a beggar. He is not beggar, but he begs to benefit the charitable who is giving in charity. He is benefited. Just like Bali Maharaj, he gave everything to Bamande. Sarvatma Satanam. There are different devotees. Out of these nine kinds of devotional service, Sarvanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Padasivanam Archanam Bandhanam Dasam Satkam Atmanivedanam. So Boli Maharaj has to part. He cultivated Atmanivedanam, giving everything to Krishna, whatever he had. So, prāṇai rathai. And Krishna says, jat karosi, jat juhosi, dadasi jat. Everyone has got some disposition to give in charity. Everyone. Perhaps you are all businessmen, you have got a separate fund for charity. That is natural inclination for everyone to give in charity. Krishna says, jat karosi, jat juhosi, dadasi, dadasi jat, purushatat madarpanam. If you are inclined to give in charity, better give it to me. Better give it to me. So here is a chance. Krishna consciousness movement, pranai rathai dhyavas. Someone should dedicate his life, someone should give in charity to his best capacity. If he has no such possibility of giving, dedicating his life or giving in charity his wealth, money, then prana rata dhyā. He can give his intelligence and ultimately he can give his words also. So this movement, this Krishna consciousness movement is very important movement. So somebody should dedicate his life, somebody should dedicate his wealth, somebody should dedicate his intelligence, and somebody should dedicate his words. So, suppose one cannot dedicate his life or he has no money, then he can give us some intelligence that if you go to such and such person, or if you do like this, if you make your plan like this for pushing your Krishna consciousness, that is also service, intelligence. And if he has no money, no intelligence, and cannot dedicate his life, then he can give his words. What is that? That word is that Krishna says, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekaṁ saraṇam-bhaja. So I have come to you, sir, to tell you that you surrender to Krishna. Please surrender to Krishna. What? There is no expenditure. But you can say, or you can say, please chant Hare Krishna. I think it is very easy. There is no expenditure, there is no loss. So, Śāstra gives us indication that prāṇai rathai bhyāvācā sreva āśaranam sada. So I am so much obliged to you that you are trying your best to push this movement, and at the same time I must say that this movement is very, very important. This is the life-giving movement to the human society. That's a fact. It is not a bogus, manufactured, concocted movement. It is authorized. Krishna says, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekaṁ saraṇam bhaja, and we are teaching this philosophy throughout the whole world, and actually from all parts of the world, we are getting devotees who have fully surrendered to Krishna.